So now we have a well-defined computational problem that's going to model what the mass spectrometer is telling us. And here we'll study a first idea of an algorithm for it. So first I'll tell you that the mass of the entire peptide is usually known. So we'll usually already know that tyrosine B1 has mass 1322. Our algorithm is going to then say, all right, let's generate every possible peptide of that mass. So in this case, for tyrosine B1, it's 1322. Let's form the spectrum of every one of those peptides. And then let's look for matches with the given spectrum among those peptides. This is an example of a brute force algorithm. So in general, a brute force algorithm is going to try all possible solutions that satisfy a certain condition. So then our question is, to determine how long is this going to take, we ask, how many peptides have a given integer mass? So in specific, how many peptides have integer mass equal to 1322? Here's a graph that shows the integer mass of a peptide versus the number of peptides that have that mass. And if we look at 1322, I've shown red lines here, we go up from 1322, and then we go over and we see it's almost at 10 to the 14th. So the answer is trillions of different peptides have this mass. And that's not going to be good. We don't want to have to consider trillions of different possibilities. So let's ask ourselves then, what is it that makes brute force so bad to begin with? Or at least this brute force algorithm. Some brute force algorithms may work well if they choose the correct condition. Here's a peptide, NQEL, right, that we're going to start working with, and another peptide, TMDH. So the total mass of NQEL is 484, and the total mass of TMDH is 484. But they're completely different, right? They don't have any of the same amino acids, and they're not going to have, so by extension, they're not going to have any of the same subpeptides. And so we need to find a way to exclude this completely. We don't want to ever have to encounter this peptide, all right? And if the way that we're going to get at that is to say, let's look at the spectra of these two peptides. So on the left here, I've shown the spectrum of TMDH. And on the right, I've shown the spectrum of NQEL. They completely disagree, right? So you may notice this. They agree at 0, and they agree at 484. And nowhere in between do they have the same two of the same masses. So we want to use this to our advantage. We want to use this to start designing an algorithm that's going to eliminate TMDH based off of its spectrum, which is not good. So our idea is, rather than try to form big peptides all at once, let's slowly build up our candidate solutions from smaller peptides. At each stage, we're going to test its spectrum and make sure it's on the right track. And if it's not on the right track, we're going to kick it out. So that's going to allow us to restrict the total number of peptides that are under consideration.